Hello, and welcome to the Center for Spiritual Living Sarasota. We're here to support you in finding a personal relationship with the God of your understanding and discovering what you already know. My name is Kathleen Frankert. I'm a licensed spiritual practitioner at the center, and I greet you today with namaste. Namaste is the Sanskrit word that means the divinity in me recognizes and honors the divinity in you. Let's begin, as we do each week, by affirming our vision and mission statement. I invite you to join in reading them with me. Our vision is empowering spiritual growth as a loving, inclusive, worldwide community. And this is our mission. We teach science of mind principles and other life-affirming spiritual truths. We explore, we learn, we grow, we connect, honoring all paths to God. We offer in-person and online weekly services, classes, workshops, affirmative prayer support, and other spiritual tools. We create opportunities for joyful social connection, community outreach, and service. We celebrate the awakening of our innate spiritual magnificence. Now let's take this opportunity to turn within, to let go of any outside concerns, events, or activities. As we prepare for our time of prayer and meditation, I invite you to connect with the breath. Allow your eyes to close as our music director, Bob Teesdale, and soloist Fawny Frost share a beautiful song written by Christy Snow. I am opening. Centered now, I recognize this new space of being as I open to the divine. I am at peace. As this is true for me, I know it is true for all hearing these words. Here and now, I turn my awareness and thoughts to the recognition that there is only one life. This life is perfect. This life is all the life there is, and it is my life now. Within that one life is all that I will ever need, want, or desire. I recognize that as I am receptive to this supply, I am supported. As I allow my consciousness to be open to it, I am guided. Good, orderly direction, God, informs my actions, directs my thoughts, and inspires me with its wisdom and counsel. Even when I think I don't know, I'm reminded that something within me does know. And so I steel my mind and listen. Listen to that inner guidance, that intuition that always knows the best and highest for me. I welcome newness in my experience, exciting ideas, dreams, and possibilities become available in common and unexpected ways. I tune in to this field of awareness that invites me to move forward in confidence and assurance. I welcome this energizing and inspiring realization. I take comfort in it, and I renew my faith by means of it. This is my good to claim now, and I do. Knowing this word is creative, I release it now for its perfect activity to unfold for all. I declare this to be so, and so it is. Today, our minister and spiritual director, Reverend Karen Wolfson, is with us to present part one of a series called Your Divine GPS. This week, she focuses on destination or distraction. Before we hear from Reverend Karen, it's my pleasure to again introduce Fawny and Bob to present an inspiring song written by India Ari, Headed in the Right Direction. Welcome, Fawny and Bob.
There's an angel showing me the way, been reaching for love all my life.
I couldn't find the wish, one step behind it.
Now I know it was mine all the time. Finally I am headed in the right direction. I can see the light of day. I've got love as my protection. There's no need for me to be afraid. Spend so much time with my head in the clouds.
I couldn't see what was happening to me.
Now I got my feet on the ground. I found that I am heading in the right direction. I can see the light of day. I've got faith and intuition telling me that I will be okay. They just dried all the tears from my eyes. Now I can see them headed in the right direction. I can see the light of day. Now I found my pearl of wisdom. There's no need for me to be afraid. Headed in the right direction. There's an angel showing me the way. I've got love as my protection. There's no need for me to be afraid. Headed in the right direction. I can see the light of day. Now I found my pearl of wisdom. There's no need for me to be afraid.
Hello, dear viewers. Pardon me for sneaking in a moment here to share a few words with you before you hear the message of today. Most of you know by now that I have been announcing my October retirement, and whoops, here we are. It's October. After many months of prayerful reflection, I realized that it's time for me to step aside and make room for new leadership of the Center for Spiritual Living Sarasota. And you know, after these recent years of the pandemic, it's so evident that we are poised on the threshold of countless exciting possibilities. And so, as our spiritual community moves into this next phase of expression, I know that the perfect new leadership will manifest. Our incredibly skilled and loving leadership team will be providing you with more information, of course, as things unfold. And you know, in reflecting on just what thoughts I would like to leave with you as we move through this adventure of change, it became clear to me that all I've been sharing during September, you know, the agony and ecstasy of change, has culminated in the very things I spoke about on two Sundays 1 year ago in October. So with the expertise of Ron Frost, who has with amazing skill and loving care been putting together these video services every Sunday since mid-March 2020, we are rebroadcasting for the next two Sundays two of those October 2021 services as reminders for you and for me to hold close as we step into the uncertainties and the immense possibilities before us. And for the remaining three Sunday broadcasts in October, you will be hearing and seeing some wonderful guest speakers. They know all about the experience of change. They have been there. And they're walking with you, our beloved spiritual community. Their messages for you will be filled with inspiration, encouragement, support, and guidance for this next phase of our journey. So stay tuned and stay connected for this adventure. You know, your presence makes it all possible. And thank you. Thank you for being in my life and in the life of our beloved Center for Spiritual Living Sarasota for all these years. Just know that I will carry you in my heart, always. Namaste. Well, thank you, Fawny and Bob. What a great song. I'm headed in the right direction. I can see the light of day. There's no need for me to be afraid. I've got faith and intuition telling me I will be okay. There's an angel showing me the way. I am headed in the right direction. Great song. If you're like me, this is true some of the time, other times not so much. And this could relate to a project or a task or how you feel about your work or your creative expression or your relationship. And no doubt this happens at more than one juncture in your life. In my life, there have been times when I was definitely headed in the direction of, oops, a painful destination I did not see. And other times I knew I was on track and headed toward a wonderful destination. There's a line in that song that resonates with me because regardless of my direction, I now can see there was, as the song says, an angel showing me the way. And that speaks to my theme for you this month, your divine GPS, or your God positioning system. That's another way of saying there's an angel showing us the way. Your divine GPS. So why this theme for October? Well, in October, autumn, it's a season of noticeable changes in nature at this time of year, and I'm more conscious of changes in all of life. The challenges, the opportunities, the uncertainties. Although we know that change is always all about growth and evolving, and it's inevitable. So this month, let's consider some awarenesses, some tools for navigating and consciously thriving in the process of change. Whether we initiate that change or the change happens to us. But first, let's check in. You know, I think about you between our times together. How are you getting along during these times of change going on all around in our world? Maybe changes in your own life, your family, things brought about by the pandemic of the past year and a half. Well, you know, you're not alone. And I want you to know it is so good knowing we're going through this together and thinking of you out there. I continue to affirm and see you as vibrantly healthy and abundantly supported in every way. And to you, our team of financial contributors, thank you for standing by us. You continue to be an absolutely essential part of all that makes it possible for us to share our message, our caring, and our connection. Thank you. So, as I was contemplating this whole idea of change and wondering what is the thing we feel we most need during times of change and the uncertainty that goes with it, one word came to mind. Guidance. Yeah, guidance. Because with change comes so much uncertainty, so many questions. And I can say that at those times, I find myself very much in need of guidance. And maybe you do too. Well, what better example of guidance than a GPS, that digital satellite informed system we have in our car or on our phone? Well, we have a spiritual guidance system available to us too. Now, here are the five Sunday topics this month. Last Sunday was your divine GPS, you are here. And that was about the first thing to do when facing any change and its unknowns is to settle down and be clear about where you are. What's your starting point? Like your GPS calibrates from where your trip is beginning. Next Sunday, your divine GPS, always on the journey. And that'll be followed by your divine GPS, find another way. And finally, wrapping it up, your divine GPS, signs are everywhere. So today, your divine GPS, destination or distractions. That's right, destination or distractions. But first I want to remind you again about guidance, divine guidance. Oh my. It is amazing. It is so brilliant, and it is so available. It's a wonder that we, and I'll include myself in that, we're so often oblivious to it. And instead, we spend so much time and energy looking for it everywhere but where it is. Here's how Ernest Holmes, the architect of our teaching, describes this marvelous divine GPS, God's positioning system. He said, we are being guided by a loving intelligence which seeks to bring us comfort, happiness, success, health, and abundance. And he says, to realize this is to know that all the wisdom, intelligence, and power of the universe is right where you are. Well, then I'll say, sign me up, right? But how do we access this divine guidance? Well, in the words of Holmes, your difficulty is not in trying to discover the place where divine guidance comes from, so much as it is in the simple acceptance that it comes through your own mind, that it is right here. He is saying God, Spirit, Higher Power, the universe, is the invisible partner in our lives going before us, preparing the way. And Holmes continues, there's something deep at the center of our being which knows what we ought to do and how we ought to do it. That sounds fantastic. But just how does it work in us? Well, by means of our intuition. That's right, your intuition. Holmes describes it this way. The divine mind has placed an inner guide at the center of everyone's being, an intuition which enables us to feel with complete certainty that everything will be all right, though we don't know the whole story. But I want to know the whole story. I want to know how this is going to work out. Well, you know that old Yiddish proverb, we plan, God laughs. You know, that's our natural human tendency. But truly, all we need to know is what and leave how to our divine GPS. It will guide us to each step. So the subtitle today, Destinations or Distractions, the subtitle to all of that, I think, should be What, Not How. That's right. What, Not How. Holmes advises us, we must put aside all questioning as to the specific means which will be employed. We're dealing with the infinite. This intelligence can draw together the means requisite for its purpose, even from the ends of the world. So back to our example, your car's GPS. You set your destination location in your GPS, and it immediately gets busy figuring out several routes, suggesting which is the best. Notice, it doesn't shout. It's calm, but persistent, just like your divine inner GPS. And on your car's GPS, if you deviate, it will calmly and repeatedly tell you how to get back on track. You know what I mean. Or finally, it will go along with you and create and calibrate and coordinate your new route, but always, always guiding you to your destination. The guidance is always there. Now let's compare that to life's journey of navigating the challenges of change. You have in mind a destination, an objective, a goal, a resolution to a problem, whatever. And most likely, if you're like me, your mind immediately gets busy figuring out the how. You know, all the things that need to happen and how they need to happen in order for you to get there. Problem is, doing that, we bump into all sorts of limitations. You know, I think you've been there, I have. I think of a particular way to do this, the how. And all of a sudden I think, oh, there's not enough, whether it's time or resources or energy or money or the right people. So what happens is we revise our desired destination or intention so that it fits into those limitations. But in doing that, we get in the way of our own infinite possibility. But if you and I simply set our intention, determine our desire, and then trust and follow our divine GPS, that inner, intuitive, infinite guidance will be, well, astonishing. We will be amazed and even amused at how we are guided, how the path opens, how resources and people and ideas and more are provided. I'm reminded of that simple scriptural promise that says, you have not, because you ask not. It's not saying you have not because you haven't figured out the how. You have not because you ask not. Doesn't say anything about the how. Now, here's the challenge. These distractions and detours along the way may seem to be taking you off the path to your destination, but also they may be taking you to something even more aligned with your soul's desire than you could have ever known. There's a simple wise saying, The path is the goal. The path is the goal. And so all these distractions don't need to permanently derail you from reaching your destination. I'll use a personal example. My years of alcoholism could be seen as a major distraction, detour. That's an understatement. It was a painful and long detour. And it took me a long, long time to see that in many ways, through my recovery program, I was brilliantly guided by my divine GPS, guided and supported in fulfilling my soul's destiny in richer and deeper ways than I could have ever imagined. It was a long and winding road, and I'm so grateful for that beautiful and loving inner GPS. Looking back, I see so clearly how the dots connected. As Steve Jobs said near the end of his life, you can't connect the dots of your life going forward. You can only connect them looking backwards. So trust the dots. They will connect. Give this a try this week. See how the dots of your life have connected so far. Guidance. I love this that Mike Dooley wrote. Don't attach to unimportant details. Don't insist on how your dreams will come true. Prepare to be astounded. It's one thing to manifest exactly what you want. It's another to bring about something even better. Now, whether facing a big change, challenge, or a small one, I'm not saying there are not moments of breaking out in a cold sweat, pounding heart, one when you wonder, oh my God, what's happening? I feel so lost. Well, here's a parable that describes this so powerfully. You may remember hearing it in one of my previous messages. It's about facing life's challenges. And by the way, change of any kind being code for growth opportunity. So here's the parable of the trapeze, the parable of the trapeze. And it's written by Danon Perry, a brilliant and remarkable humanitarian. In fact, I recommend you Google for his story. He's an amazing man and did so, so much good. The spelling is D-A-N-A-A-N-P-A-R-R-Y, Perry, Danon Perry. So listen to this and see if you can relate. He says, sometimes I feel that my life is a series of trapeze swings. I'm either hanging on to a trapeze bar just swinging along, or for a few moments I'm hurtling across space in between trapeze bars. Most of the time I spend my life hanging on for dear life to my trapeze bar of the moment. Career, relationship, home, location, a way of doing something. And it carries me along at a certain steady rate of swing, and I have the feeling that I'm in control of my life. But every once in a while, as I'm swinging along, I look out ahead of me into the distance, and what do I see? I see another trapeze bar swinging toward me. It's empty, and I know in that place in me that knows that this new trapeze bar has my name on it. It is coming to get me. In my heart of hearts, I know that for me to grow, I must release my grip on this present well-known bar and move to the new one. But each time it happens to me, I hope I won't have to let go of my old bar completely before I grab the new one. Yet in my inner knowing place, I know that I must totally release my grasp on my old bar. And for some moment in time, I must hurtle across space before I can grab onto that new bar. Each time I'm filled with terror. It doesn't matter that in all my previous hurdles across the void of unknowing, I have always made it. I am each time afraid that this time I'll miss. But I do it anyway. No guarantees, no net. No insurance policy, but I do it anyway, because somehow to keep hanging on to that old bar is no longer on the list of alternatives. So for an eternity that can last a microsecond or a thousand lifetimes, I soar across the dark void of the path of the past, the dark void, where the past is gone and the future is not yet here. I call that transition, he says. I've come to believe that this transition is the only place that real change occurs. And the bars are illusions we dream up to avoid that space where real growth occurs for us. And hurtling through the void, we just may learn how to fly. I can relate. Author Tama Keeves says, it's okay to feel as though you don't know what's going on. You don't. You can't supervise creativity and evolution, so stop figuring it out. Let it out. I like that. Stop figuring it out. Let it out. And now, Fawny and Bob are going to take us into our week with Janice Stanfield's song that says, let your life lead you where you need to go. What she's saying is, you can trust your inner, infinite, intuitive, divine GPS. Have fun with this, and I'll see you next week.
I start losing my smile. I say to myself, what's the deal? What exactly's the point? Getting all out of joint, not liking the way that I feel. Maybe I believe that it's all up to me, at the helm of this boat all alone, till some stormy detail takes the wind from my sail to remind me what I've always known. Oh, relax and let the river flow. Let your life teach you what you need to know. Let your life lead you where you need to go. Let your life teach you what you need to know. Let your life lead you where you need to go. Swimming upstream, chasing a dream, make sure that it comes from the heart. If you're fighting the tide for glory or fame, you might be just working too hard. Are you winning the race? Are you swimming in place and still falling further behind? There's a current below that knows where to go. Carry you to peace of mind. Oh, relax and let the river flow. Let your life teach you what you need to know. Let your life lead you where you need to go. Let your life teach you what you need to know. Let your life lead you where you need to go. Let your life teach you what you need to know. Let your life lead you where you need to go. Let your life teach you what you need to know. Let your life lead you where you need to go.
Thank you, Fawny and Bob. We are so grateful for the musical inspiration and talents you share with us. And Reverend Karen, we appreciate your reminders about how to tune into divine guidance that is always available. We affirm for you that this guidance is abundantly available to you as you prepare for this next phase of your ministry and retirement. Blessings to you always. At the Center for Spiritual Living Sarasota, we're here to support you in a variety of ways. And now it is time to share our offering that supports our ability to continue to be here for you. There are three easy ways to contribute. On your screen, you'll see our website, www.cslsarasota.com. On the left side of the screen, select the donate button, which will bring up several options for making a contribution. You can contribute via PayPal or by credit card, or mail a check to our address shown there on the website, or you can also set up automatic contributions through your own online banking. Selecting the Donate Now button will also open the PayPal window. And now I invite you to take your virtual gift in your hand, placing it over your heart. Bless it as you share with me and know with me. My gift goes forth to heal, to bless, and to prosper, and the divine flow returns it to me, multiplied abundantly. And now let us declare together our offering affirmation. The words are on your screen. I give thanks that I may share of my good, my love, and my support. Thank you so much. I have a couple of reminders to share. Our Spiritual Living Circle meets every Wednesday at 7 p.m., led by licensed spiritual practitioner Jim Grove. Each week, we discuss an article from this month's Science of Mind magazine. This Wednesday, the topic is The Spiritual Idea Behind Your Finances by Ernest Holmes. This circle is open to all at no charge, and you can come and go as you like. Newcomers are always welcome, too. To receive a copy of the article and discussion guide, please send Jim an email at the address shown here. Hope to see you Wednesday. And are you facing a challenge or seeking support for a special intention in your life? Then I invite you to visit the website and click on the green prayer request button. We have five licensed spiritual practitioners, Ron Frost, Jim Grove, Nicole Leeds, Sean Scanlon, and me, who are available to know and affirm spiritual truth with and for you. Our practitioners are also available by appointment for 1-hour spiritual coaching sessions. These sessions offer the opportunity to explore a deeper understanding and practical application of the spiritual truth in the midst of your problem or challenging issue. For more information, check out their page at our website by selecting the staff tab on the left, then click on practitioners. Also on our website, you can sign up to receive our weekly email newsletter or check out our Facebook page for posts about upcoming events and find past services and videos on our YouTube channel. And now as we conclude our sacred time together, let us do so with the intention to live in love, health, and peace. I invite you to listen or join in singing our closing song, Let There Be Peace on Earth. Thank you so much for being with us.
Step I take, let this be my song.